Welcome. In this training, we'll be going over a pretty easy topic, the unit step. As a friendly warning, there will be a personal touch project at the end to help you better understand how to create groups to better organize your fleet. The tab to the furthest right of the top bar will be the units tab. It should be noted that the monitoring and units tab have different functions. At the top of this tab's work area, you'll see two options, units and groups. We'll come back to group listings a little bit later in this tutorial. Below the new button, you can see an A to Z icon. This sorts out the units list alphabetically. To the right of each unit listed is the unit properties wrench. Let's select the wrench. There's a lot of stuff in here, but we'll only uncover the basics in this tutorial. In the general tab of the unit properties, we'll see a name field top at the top of this area. This field is directly related to how the unit appears on the maps and monitoring tab. You can also select the icon tab in the same window. If you select the icon library, you can actually see our selection of over 200 icons to choose from. If none of ours quite fit the design you're looking for, you can click on the box showing the current unit icon to upload your own custom icon. Feel free to customize these as you please, but remember that icon changes for everyone, not just for yourself. Let's exit the unit properties window. To the right of the wrench, you'll see a unit copy icon represented by two pieces of paper. We'll go further into this function in the advanced Create a Unit tutorial. Last on the unit list is the X. If the X is red, it means you have the access to delete this unit. If it's gray, it means the button is null. Be careful, if you delete the unit by mistake, immediately report the issue. The support team will have 30 days to escalate this issue and restore the unit from the time you deleted it. Let's return to the top of the work area. And now we'll select the groups list. Many of these functions will remain the same as the units list, such as sort, copy, and delete. So we'll skip over those. You'll note that this selection looks a little bit different though, as now the items on the list have a plus to the left and a number in parentheses to the right. The plus is the expansion button and allows you to see the units within that group without opening the group properties wrench. The number in parentheses to the right is the number of units indicator. It shows you the number of units in the group without having to manually count them out. Similar to unit properties, you can select the group parameters to rename this item. You can also place multiple units in the group from the general tab. In most cases, you can just double-click the units in placing in the group, but there are other controls. You can either hold control and select multiple items before pushing the devices over to the right side of the box. You can also choose the select all button at the bottom and shift them to the other side. The group icon tab looks very familiar. In fact, this tab works exactly like the unit icon tab. From the libraries of icons to the custom upload will all be the same. For this personal touch project, we'll be creating a group. First, make sure you're on the groups list and at the top of the work area under the units tab. Since we're creating a group, we're going to select the new button. Now let's name our group, training group. Go ahead and select some of the units that we're placing in this group. I'll choose bus 1, truck 2, and Phoenix food truck. I'm going to make sure they're all on the correct side. Now I'll just click OK. My unit group is successfully created. Congratulations and thank you for completing our tutorial on the units tab. I hope by now you feel a little more at ease when operating through our platform. To further extend your knowledge of our platform, check out our other video tutorials for more specific trainings. I'll see you next time!